10 years ago, Ed Howard was charged with espionage in a federal criminal complaint just days after fleeing his Santa Fe home. He is accused of meeting with the KGB in Europe and accepting money in exchange for classified information. Howard had been trained for a top secret Moscow assignment by the CIA, but was fired shortly before his departure to Russia. The government claims a bitter Ed Howard retaliated by handing the Soviets a blueprint to the CIA's Moscow operation. It's alleged Howard's information led the KGB to Soviet citizens working for the CIA. At least one of them, Adolf Tolkachev, was later executed.
Howard was to be Tolkachev's conduit to the CIA, that you were responsible for him and that you were also responsible for his death. Your response?
Not true. Absolutely not true. I was sent for the technical project in Moscow.
The CIA had trained Ed Howard to come here to Moscow under diplomatic cover, where he would secretly tap into underground Soviet communication lines relating to laser technology.
I wasn't to run human agents. The reason, even though I was trained to run human agents, and I could back up to another officer who was running human agents, the project was so important and was such a great investment in terms of dollars and number of man hours that we didn't want the person who was running my project, or that I was to work on, to get involved with the human agent, because that could mean that that officer would be exposed to the KGB. I took a lot of heat for many years for the rolling up of a number of our assets, our agents here in Moscow, and it just wasn't possible because I wasn't here to support them.
In fact, Howard denies selling any secrets to the KGB, although he admits flirting with the idea. He says he never followed through with it. But by September 1985, the FBI had acquired evidence to formally charge Howard with espionage. Before they could arrest him, Howard fled Santa Fe. He sought protection in the Soviet Union, and only then, Howard claims, did he approach the KGB.
What I gave the KGB, really? A major propaganda victory. Yeah, of course, I had conversations with them. They were very interested in knowing about the CIA in terms of personnel policies, how people join the CIA, how people work in the CIA, et cetera, et cetera. Stuff of a general nature. But in terms of the giving national defense information to a foreign power, nothing. I've never done anything that would endanger my friends, families, relatives in the United States. Oh yeah, there's probably going to be some prosecutor someplace is going to say, oh, it was classified information.
Back in Albuquerque, U.S. Attorney John Kelly disputes Howard's claim.
He would have been indicted in 1985 had he remained in the jurisdiction. We believe there is more than sufficient evidence to indict him now should he return.
Yuri Kobolatsky is a spokesman for the Russian Foreign Intelligence Service, successor to the KGB. We met with him at his Moscow office.
Can we assume that he provided valuable information to the Soviet government at that time?
I think so, yes. We can assume that any intelligence officer, you know, who was working for major intelligence service and who voluntarily cooperated with us, of course he was very valuable.
The KGB had a mole in the CIA. Ed Howard says it wasn't him. Tomorrow night, the Ames connection. Larry Barker for Target 7.